Okay, well, we're going to go ahead and get started. And I would like to introduce our wonderful, illustrious superintendent who just came back from a great meeting, I understand. So Dr. Cruz, would you welcome everyone and give them a little update about what's going on in the fabulous Pendergast District?
Absolutely. Good morning and welcome, everyone. I so appreciate you taking time to be here this morning. I just had a great opportunity to connect with some colleagues who are soon to be part of our Pendergast family. So really, really excited about that. You know, as we are wrapping up the school year, what we are most excited about right now is the incredible opportunity that's in front of us. Because the federal government has made that decision to reinvest so much money into public education, we have this amazing opportunity to reimagine what's happening at our schools. And so next year, you're going to see quite a bit of innovation. We're so excited that we're going to be bringing in new instructional materials, new opportunities for our students, and hopefully new opportunities for our families and for our business partners to partner with us. So that's what we're really excited about right now. At our June 24th meeting, we are going to ask for all of you to help us. We are interested in you all partnering with us as we are reimagining what's happening in our schools. Our principals are having community meetings. They've brought together design teams. They're having incredible conversations. And we are very excited to have you all become part of that dialogue. So be on the lookout. We're going to be asking you to join us in that next adventure. And we're also so excited about the programming that you are going to see today. So my thanks to everyone at the Dual Language Academies, at all that amazing programming that's been happening for our students. We're so excited to be expanding that in the future. We're going to have more students that have more access to this really important learning. And I just want to thank everyone from our incredible governing board to our leaders, our teachers, our students, our families and business partners. You have hung in there with us and have absolutely been incredible. And I couldn't appreciate you anymore. So thank you to all of you for your efforts. I believe that we have some of our incredible members of our governing board here in the meeting with us today. So I am going to quickly take a look and see, and I do believe that Ms. Ortega Rosales is here. Would you like to welcome our community?
Thank you, Dr. Cruz. Yes, thank you to everyone who has diligently attended and participated in these lunch and learn opportunities that we've had in the last year. We know that being in person is the best to be able to connect with each other and have that wonderful lunch or breakfast that is served by our Chartwell's partners. But we also have learned a lot this year about the opportunity that perhaps we could do something virtually for those who cannot attend in person. And so please make sure that you do fill out the survey that Ms. Shafir has shared with you, in that we want to hear from you. Our goal is to be able to reach out to all our community, in particular our parents and our business partners and our nonprofit partners who do join us in this virtual and soon hopefully face-to-face communication and community partnership that we have in this event. We want your feedback, and we need to be open to how you would like to participate with Pendergast and all of the great things that we're doing for our children. So thank you for being here, and I look forward to today's presentations.
Thank you so much. We also have Ms. Sue Saren here from our governing board. Ms. Saren, would you like to welcome our guests?
Thank you, Dr. Cruz. Good morning, everyone. It's great to see everyone. I know we're on Zoom, but you know, it's great that you're coming to the Lunch and Learns. It's hard to believe that our school year is almost over. Hard in one way, you know, it was a long year, I will say that. But all of a sudden, you know, we're at the end of the year, we're gonna have promotions next week. It's gonna be a great time. And I do wanna thank all of our staff for everything you did this year. It was probably one of the hardest years you've ever had. I know for me as a board member, with the decisions we had to make and everything, it was tough. And I want to thank our parents and community and our business partners. You gave the Pendergast District the support it needed to do what we had to do. And truly, we are number one because of all of you. And I do appreciate all of you. I look forward to the presentations today. And I do want to give out a shout out to Ms. Shapir for planning these lunch and learns, for everything you have done for the Pendergast District. You are an amazing woman, and I really appreciate you, Netta. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I really, really appreciate it. For those of you who don't know why she's thanking me, it's because I'm retiring in June after 7 amazing years with Pendergast District, and now time to spend that time with my grandkids who have been waiting during the pandemic to see me. So thank you so much to everybody. You know, normally we give Zoom tips, but I think you're the ones that could give us the Zoom tips instead of us giving them to you. You know very well how to use this wonderful Zoom. I mean, that's become part of our vocabulary. We're Zooming, we Zoom, we Zoomed, you know, all of that. But we love reading the chats. We save the chats, we look at them, we share them, and we learn from them. So please, that's a way, even though we can't be in person, for us to interact together. So if you have questions or comments or compliments or anything, just put them in there, because it gives a lot of joy to people, and we do review them. So you know how to do that. You know to mute your microphone. You're great at that. So we appreciate that. And you all get gold stars for your Zoom behavior. Thank you. And we do have some wonderful presentations today. And our CFO, Joanne Fimbres, who's absolutely incredible. No one knows more than she does about finance. I'm not kidding. She's unbelievable. She's going to give some information about a potential bond election that may be coming up in November. Joanne is very skilled, has done a lot of work in terms of assessment, looking at needs and things like that. And so she's going to share that information with you. And if you have questions, comments, or anything, just put them in the chat and she will be more than happy to answer them. So Joanne, take it away.
Thank you, Netta. Thank you, Dr. Cruz, and our governing board members who are with us today. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, community. I'm so happy to see you. It's great to see you guys, even if it is in our Zoom squares. As we get started, and actually, Dr. Cruz, do you want to cover this, or do you want me to go ahead and just dive right in?
Oh my goodness, you can dive right in, my friend. I appreciate that.
Thank you. Just wanted to give you the opportunity if you wanted. So as we start looking at the possibility of a recommendation to our governing board for a bond election, one thing that I want to cover with the entire group that's with us this morning is the fact that our district, we cover 20 square miles. So if you didn't know that, yes, we do. We have 20 square miles that occupy three different cities, Glendale, Avondale, and Phoenix. And that is 12 kindergarten through eighth grade campuses. And we do serve approximately about 8,200 students from preschool to eighth grade. And we're very proud of each and one of those students that we have. And taking a look at our demographics, as you can see, you know, there's quite a bit of history, quite a bit of background with regards to the demographics that we have in our students, with 75% of our students being Hispanic. So we have a large array of demographic and cultural backgrounds in our classroom, and we're very proud of that. So wanting to talk about the bond election and the recommendation that we are seeking to take to our governing board over the summer, the district is interested in the special bond election that would be held on Tuesday, November 2nd of this year, 2021. So what exactly is a bond? Bonds are basically loans that are made to school districts, used to purchase capital items and to make capital improvements to our facilities, our buildings, and gives us the opportunity to renovate our classrooms and purchase school buses as two of the major areas of bond proceeds. So in our research, we do have to have a needs assessment before we truly have that conversation with our governing board. So what exactly is the need of our district? We know that we you know, have been continuing with the current bond that we have now. We've been working to renovate our classroom, refurbish our district facilities. We have upgraded our technology, and we've purchased new buses and district vehicles that have, you know, aged and have large mileage, a great amount of mileage on those vehicles. So our current bond has given us the ability to do that, but we know that it's coming to an end. So we would like the ability, our needs assessment has proven that we basically would like the ability to continue the great work that we have been encompassing over our district facilities and our capital items. So two major factors with regards to bond elections: the impact of our state budget reductions and the state budget reductions for maintenance, school facilities repairs, and capital projects. And as a result, bond funding is the only mechanism to begin to restore, repair, and refurbish those existing facilities. So over the past number of years, our capital budget has been reduced at the state level with the legislature budget cuts. And so with that being said, school districts do look to bond elections to have the ability to have that capital capacity to do the work that we need to on our facilities and our capital needs. So in our assessment and in our research, we looked at our construction projects, our technology, the renovations that are needed for our facilities, and our replacement plan for our vehicles. And that basically gave us the basis to propose a 2021 bond election of $53.5 million. Going into, you know, this coming November's bond election. So that's what we're seeking to take to our governing board and the possibility of a call for election. So talking about construction projects, we have classroom innovations. If you've been in and by our schools, you have seen that there has been a number of items and work that has been done at each of our campuses. We are in the midst of our third classroom renovation project right now. We do know that we have we did do a classroom renovation at Via de Paz, Desert Mirage, and we are now actively working at Garden Lakes. And of course, we would like to continue that great work in our classrooms and renovating those classrooms. You know, obviously, we know that with the development that's coming up in and around our boundaries, we know that there may be a possibility that we will need some new classroom additions. So we are looking forward to these developments, bringing new families, young children that can then occupy our school sites. And we would need to possibly add additional classrooms on certain campuses that have additional growth. So taking a look at technology, we know that with our current bond, we have the ability of bringing in one-to-one devices for our students. So our kindergarten through eighth grade students, every one of our students has a Chromebook that they can use for their instruction on a daily basis. We have increased our wireless capacity throughout the district, and we've made improvements and replacements and upgrades to our district technology to be able to support the technology that we've provided to our students and our staff. And we know that technology ages, so we want to go ahead and keep that technology built into an upcoming bond election so that we continue to upgrade and maintain the technology that our students and staff members have. So looking at repairs and replacements, we have been actively working on camera and intercom systems for our school sites. That is a project that we would like to continue in the next bond election, installing safety and security features. You know, cameras, intercoms, yes, that is highly regarded as safety, but we also have to take a look at our fire alarms and our security systems for our campuses and being able to replace those and upgrade those. Roof replacements, we know that we have been active in working on repairing and replacing our roofs at all of our campuses. And so I know that you can't necessarily see the shingles or the flat roofs on our buildings, but please know that we have been actively working to take care of those roofs. That way, when we do have a storm or any inclement weather, our roofs are well-maintained and keeping everyone under those roofs nice and safe. Same with flooring. We know that there are flooring projects that need to occur in our schools, and we have been actively working to replace any flooring in each of our classrooms and in our buildings. So those are projects that we would like to continue. And our most recent project, for those of you that are at Amberlea, we most recently, prior to the students returning, we did have a flooring replacement for all of those classrooms. So if you are a family or if you have students at Amberlea, please know that we have new carpeting in those classrooms, and we're very proud of that. And at the same time, it also allows us the ability to replace the furniture. So when we're doing classroom renovations, we have new furniture and upgraded furniture going into those classrooms. And then again, we take a look at our vehicles. We know that our buses, you know, have aged, and we do have them on a replacement plan. So the bond dollars allow us to phase in the replacement of those aging buses and our vehicle fleet. And so if you, you know, as you're driving down the road and you see a shiny new bus, please know that those are your bond dollars actively at work, and we would like to continue that replacement plan of the aging fleet. So one thing that I do want to share with you, and what is important to know, is that there is no tax rate increase. There would be no tax rate increase as a result of a successful passage of a bond election. Because we've had a current bond and we are looking to seek going into the new bond election, there would not be a tax rate increase. This is basically, you know, allowing us the ability to continue the great work that we have been doing. So the Pendergast District is committed to the responsible stewardship of bond funds, and it is Arizona law that requires districts to clearly identify how bond proceeds are spent within the voter information pamphlet. And school districts must hold public hearings annually to inform the public on the progress of how the bond proceeds are spent. Please know that we do this every fall. That is a requirement. We are meeting that law. But in addition, we do bring information to our governing board at least twice a year. And that is because we are so proud of the work that we are doing. And we want to be able to showcase that and share that information with our community. Communication on the bond fund usage will be shared with stakeholders on a consistent basis on our district website and other social media channels, communication channels that we have. There will be an oversight committee that is appointed by the superintendent that will be established, consisting of district staff, community members, parents, and business leaders, to report to the governing board and our stakeholders on the progress and the accountability of each of those projects that we have under the bond. So I wanted to let you know the bond election, it would be on November 2nd of 2021, this year. And early voting for this measure would begin, or actually would start, on October 6th of this year, 2021. And the last date to register for voter registration is October 4th of this year. And that is the link, or that is the website under Service Arizona Voter Registration, if you are interested in getting registered to vote. And with that being said, I know I can see that there's items coming up in the chat. I don't know if there's any questions, but if Netta says that there's some time permitting, I would be more than happy to answer any questions that you may have. So I'm just checking the chat to see if there are questions.
Joanne, excellent job. So clear and concise. We really appreciate it. The great thing is that you can see all the progress that's been made in our schools. And Mr. Pohlmeier right now is working on our annual report, and he's going to be featuring a lot of our projects. So that's going to be posted on our website. We'll also send it out to all of you. So you will get it and be able to see. And hopefully someday when we're all back in person, Dr. Cruz, maybe everyone will go on a field trip and we'll get to see some of the some of our school sites and how they have been modernized. And it's really a joy to see them and just the pride that our schools take in these. So if you have any questions, you certainly can reach out to me or to Ms. Fembrace. And I'm just so proud of the work that the district has done and how all of the students are benefiting from this. So do we have any questions that anybody would like Ms. Fembrace to answer? I know it will be a mail-in ballot only election. Is that correct, Ms. Fembrace?
Yes, that is correct.
Right. And also we have right on the center of our webpage at PESD92.org, you can go right there and in 2 minutes register to vote. So we just want you to know that also, if you haven't, if you so desire. And so without any further ado, we've got another fantastic presentation for you from Sonoran Sky Elementary. And how many of you would like to learn another language or already know another language? Yes. Well, we're going to learn the reasons why it's important that you learn another language. Yes. All right. Well, maybe that's something that we can think of. All right. Hands up if you either know another language or you want to know another language. Yes, it's so important. And we're going to hear why. Why is it so important to learn other languages? What are the benefits? We have students now that are in the Dual Language Academy, and you're going to learn about them from Maria Wheeler, who is a dual language teacher there, and also Julia Soto, who is at our district office. And Julia works with our English language learners and just does an amazing job of supporting all of our schools. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to these amazing ladies. And I think we're also going to have a wonderful presentation by some of our students. So we're really anxious to see all the great things that you have in store for us. And pay close attention, because this may be your first steps in becoming bilingual. Listen up, everybody.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Julia Soto, and I am so excited to speak to you about our dual language program. Oops, Maria, if you could go back just a little bit. You're awesome. First of all, I want to thank Maria for being my my person who's working with the PowerPoint. So she is our wonderful bilingual Spanish dual language kindergarten first grade teacher, and she is at Sonoran Sky, the West Valley to begin. I hear that other districts are copying our program already, and so. We're just strengthening our program, and it's really exciting. So first of all, I want to thank our board members and our superintendent and our director of curriculum for your support for all, throughout all these years. So here are our Dual Language Academy goals. We want to have dual language ambassadors. That means that our teachers and our students, and especially our family members, are out there supporting our program and giving the community the outreach and telling them about our program, building a multicultural community, retaining our dual language teachers, and program consistency. Go ahead, Maria. So this aligns with our profile of a graduate that Dr. Cruz has been out working with our community about, and making sure that when we have students who graduate from our program, we want to achieve that high, that students are bilingual, biliterate in both English and Spanish, that they're communicating effectively, and that we continue to create partnerships throughout this program. Oh, and Netta was talking about the benefits of being bilingual. So first of all, it improves brain power. It enhances memory. It helps maintain memory and cognitive abilities as you get older, which is really good for me. It increases your ability to multitask. It opens doors to other cultures and traditions. It enhances decision-making and problem-solving, and it helps improve your first language. So our dual language model begins in kindergarten. We have 50% instruction is delivered in Spanish, and 50% of the instruction is delivered in English. We are working on that simultaneous literacy instruction so that students are receiving reading strategies in the language that correlates to one another, that vocabulary development, and trying to gain that fluency in both languages. So as you know, in kindergarten, they are their brains are so sponge-worthy that it's really great to start there and then to continue all the way up into the upper grades. So next year, we are excited to have our dual language program to be at one school site. We did have it at other school sites, and I want to thank the leadership at the other school sites for all of their helped and support with the program, but this year we decided we're going to enhance it at one school site. And you can see Maria Wheeler there, our fantastic kindergarten teacher. And that way, we are going to have a cultural strand at Sonoran Sky. It's going to be a study of social and cultural components of the society. We're going to continue with our professional development, and we want to expand it to the upper grades, which is going to be really exciting. And we want to involve more stakeholders. Go ahead, Maria. I love this picture of Miss Maria, and she is going to be speaking about the program over at Sonoran Sky. So this is probably the most exciting part. Take it away, Maria.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Soto. So my name is Maria Wheeler. Sorry. I am a kindergarten first grade teacher at Sonoran Sky Elementary. I am the Spanish dual language teacher. And I've had the fortune of being in our district for the past 21 years and very, very excited to represent the Dual Language Academy today. 7 years ago, I was approached and I was asked, would you like to maybe be a Spanish dual language teacher and start this program? I did not hesitate. It was an instant, yes, please, where do I sign up? And the reason why I was so excited is, you know, I grew up with this gift of being bilingual and biliterate. I grew up in the beautiful enchanted island of Puerto Rico, where the language is Spanish, but my home language was English as I was growing up. So I grew up, I did not know any different. That was just the way it was. And as an adult, I've realized, you know, all these benefits that we talk about, I have experienced them. Job opportunities. I've always felt like I had an ace in my pocket, you know, not just to get the job, but opportunities within the careers that I've had. I've had wonderful opportunities for growth. Making connections in my cognitive abilities. As my children were growing up, I have a daughter that went into dental hygiene. And she was taking her medical board exams and she's like, Mom, I need a little bit of help with this. And our, you know, medical stuff, no, not me, but okay, I'll help you. I'm the teacher, I can do this. And I remember looking at the terminology and the stuff that she was doing and going, oh, I know what that means. And it was just making those connections because I had that ability to speak another language. So I love being a teacher. That is my passion. But now I also get to give the gift of biliteracy to my students. And that is just a cherry on top. So I'm very, very excited to be here presenting for the Pendergast District, our wonderful Dual Language Academy. Before I really start on it, I'm gonna stop share for a second and give you a view of my class because they are all here and they're very excited. They see parents out there, everybody wave. They are so very excited to be here also. They're so proud of everything that they've done. I've done a little bit of research and I found out that in our whole world, 60% of the world speaks more than one language. 43% of the world speaks more than one language. Another 13% speaks three languages. Another 3% speaks more than three languages. We're giving that to our students here at Pendergast District. So that's where my passion and my excitement comes from. So real quick, I'm going to go through my presentation. Here's a better view of my kindergarten class. And also Mrs. Felix, my first grade and kindergarten English counterpart was here. She's watching the kiddos as we're doing this. This is her class too. First grade classroom, they're also here with me. Some of them are online, but these are my cutie pies. Our typical day in dual language at Sonoran Sky, we do kindergarten through third grade. We are working on increasing to fourth grade and hopes of going all the way through. We do use as Ms. Soto said the 50-50 dual language model, which we did have the fortune of being trained by Dr. Gomez himself for the Gomez and Gomez model. And one of the components that we use is called the language of the day. This is where we do all of our routines and our rituals on a language of the day. So on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, we will use the language of Spanish for our greetings, our school family, our end of day, walking in line. We also try to teach a phrase every week. And then on Tuesday and Thursday, we will do it in English so that they're getting these routines and everything in both languages every day. Academic day, they'll have the Spanish language arts for half the day. They'll do reading, writing, speaking, and listening. Science and social studies is taught in Spanish. And then they go the other half of the day with the English teacher, and they do their English language arts with reading, writing, speaking, and listening. And then they do the content of math in English. So this is what our day looks like. A little bit later, you're going to see a video which will have a little part of the language of the day so you can experience it. When they finish kindergarten, they will be reading in two languages. They will be writing in two languages. They will be gaining that self-confidence and connections with their culture, their identity. They will do a lot of cooperative learning. They will work in groups. They will do a lot of discovery. We do project-based learning. In this picture, they had made little robots out of the head of a toothbrush, and they were, you know, testing out how they can get it to go in different directions. So they'll do all kinds of amazing things. We will focus on the Hispanic heritage, their traditions and their holidays, but not just Hispanic heritage and culture. They're gonna be learning about all of the cultures around the world. This is when we were in person. They got to do this 3 months project where they focus on just one country, each group, and then they get to present to the community and school. We were able to do this also online. This is my online group where they had 3 months to learn about one country, and they presented beautifully online too. And then right here, I'm gonna end my part of the presentation. I have a video. The first part of the video will be the routines that I talked about, the language of the day, and then it's gonna go into a dance. I'm going to encourage everybody, if you feel the need, please stand up and dance with us. This is a fun song, one of their favorites, and I know that many of the parents and siblings, they got up and they danced with us. I already see my kiddos standing up ready to dance. So no further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and present my dual language class. Enjoy.
Clase, clase. Sí. Nuestro lenguaje del día es español. Vamos a comenzar nuestro día. Primero vamos a decir buenos días.
Buenos días.
Nosotros somos una familia de escuela. Mi trabajo es mantenerlo seguro. ¿Y tu trabajo es?
Mantenerlo así.
Mantenerlo así. Good morning, class.
Good morning.
We are a school family. It is my job to keep you safe, and your job is?
To keep it that way.
Very nice job. Okay, nosotros vamos a bailar el baile del gorila. Recuerda, escucha cómo vas a hacer los movimientos, y recuerda cuando son manos arriba, manos abajo, y caminando como el gorila, ¿ok? ¿Están listos?
Sí, sí.
Ok.
Cuerda, ya no
That concludes my part of the presentation. Oops, hope it didn't go off again. So muchas gracias, everybody.
Oh my gosh, I'm out of breath from dancing. That was absolutely, let's give it up, everybody, for Julia and Maria. That was absolutely, and the kids, that was absolutely incredible. And what a taste we got for really what goes on every day in our amazing dual language classroom. So, you have questions, you're gonna unmute if there are questions, comments. My question is, but what if I don't live in the district and I really wanna come to Pendergast? Dr. Cruz, can I come? Can I bring
Absolutely. Oh my gosh, yes. Tell your friends and family, tell your neighbors. We have opportunities for everyone to come to Pendergast. We've got lots of spots in open enrollment right now at all 12 schools. And absolutely, we have open enrollment at Sonoran Sky, the Dual Language Academy. So please get the word out that we are accepting open enrollment. And get registered soon. We need to make sure that we save your spot.
Am I too old to be in a dual language classroom learning in that kindergarten classroom? That's my question.
Well, you know, Ms. Shafir, I think you've kept your teaching certificate up, so we can use you, my friend.
That's right. I think you can see the excitement. You can see the benefits of being bilingual. And one of the things that we talked about when we were planning the presentation with Julia and Maria is the fact that we are a global society, and we're doing business with people around the world. So having those skills, when you go into the workforce, that is such a plus. And so many jobs right now are saying bilingual preferred. And just imagine having a student, having your child who has that skill. There are schools around that charge an absolute fortune to teach another language to children. And here we're doing it for free. And not just doing it. Look at the high level that this is being taught at. So we are so grateful for Maria Wheeler. Just, you can just feel her passion. Julia, for all the support, our governing board, as everyone said, our superintendent, really, really important to know about options. You know, sometimes we have a tendency to think of school about when we went to school, but let's think of school as far as how do we plan for the future and what will the future look like for our students? That's what Pendergast District is doing. So if you have questions or comments or anything that you would like to say to Ms. Wheeler or to Ms. Soto, we would love to hear them. But we also want to let you know, as Dr. Cruz said, registration is open. So maybe you don't have children, but we ask other people to check us out. And Dr. Cruz, you just visited this morning. You and Ms. Pohlmeier had an opportunity to visit with a group of people. Could you tell us a little bit about that for a few minutes?
Sure, absolutely. So we had the opportunity to meet with the Women's Council of Realtors for the West Valley. And that was fantastic to hear about the current housing market. I believe they said that they have about 300 people for every listing. So there are 300 potential buyers for every listing. So I told them it was extremely affirmational. I'm never leaving my home, and I'm so thankful to be in education. It really sounds like they are working really, really hard right now in the real estate industry. And, you know, we invited them to come to one of our real tours. We want to make sure that they know all the incredible opportunities for families here in the Pendergast School District. And again, I would really encourage all of you to get connected with one of our schools. Our principals are currently working on planning for the expansion of STEAM academies. So we will have STEAM academies available at every school. They're going to look different because every community wants something a little bit different for their students. But the opportunity for open enrollment is there. You can absolutely bring your student to any one of our 12 incredible schools. You're going to hear more about our STEAM academies in the future, but we really do need your help. We need your partnership. So please do reach out to a school. We would love to have you on one of our planning teams.
That's great, Dr. Cruz. We're reaching out too. We have tremendous development going on within our district boundaries. And we're reaching out to all those new home developments to let them know that they are Pendergast students. We can't wait to have them. And so if you know anybody who's looking for a place, there are incredible opportunities all over the West Valley. And we welcome the students to come to Pendergast District. So what about if people want to know information? Oh my gosh, look at that. We have so many ways to keep connected with us. You can join us on Facebook, on Twitter, on YouTube. You can see some incredible videos. We're on Instagram. Ray is so unbelievable in terms of updating our website every single day. So we don't have stale news here. We have all kinds of refresh things every day, your opportunity to comment, your opportunity to share so that you know what's going on. We were just featured for our amazing program in partnership with ASU and our ASU Prep Digital program. So Dr. Cruz, I'm gonna call on you again just for a little shout out about that because that's been featured all over.
Absolutely. I think that folks don't know that because we are not a K-12 school district, we don't have high school accreditation. So in order for students to be able to transfer their high school credits from one high school to another, they need to have attended a high school that is accredited. That also helps them with NCAA eligibility and potential scholarships. So being a K-8 school district, we had to come up with an innovative way to provide those opportunities for our students to earn high school credit while they were still in middle school, if that was something that they wanted to pursue. And so we are absolutely thrilled to death. We've been in partnership with ASU Prep Digital for a number of years now. We've been expanding the program. Our pass rates are unparalleled. We have 98% pass rates, which by the way, for us, means having earned an A or a B in the course. I know that in one of my graduate programs, someone said C's get degrees, but not in Pendergast. In Pendergast, we get A's and B's, and we make sure that students have a very high GPA as they're moving on into their high school career. So we're absolutely thankful for that partnership. In fact, you'll notice that ADE recently invested quite a bit of money into ASU Prep Digital to provide that resource to other school districts. And that is in no small part to the success that we have found in that partnership. ADE had actually called upon us to give input and some advice to other school districts that might be interested in that kind of programming. So we're very excited to have led the way for that. We're very good at it. And we really do want to expand those opportunities to more students. So that's another investment that we'll be looking to make in the future to make sure that every student that is ready to start earning high school credit can do that. For the long term, for those of you with young children at home, I can tell you that as a parent, it was really helpful to have my college student go into college with 45 credit hours already having been completed because that's going to save us lots of money. And as it turns out, it's also going to save some time. And now she's excited about that possibility too. So, definitely encourage your students over the summer, during those times when they can take those dual enrollment classes to get on that, to take advantage of those opportunities. Tolleson Union High School District has a lot of dual enrollment opportunities for students. And so it really really encourage you to take advantage of that. It can really help in the long run. So parents, it can be hard in the short term to get kids excited about that, but I'm telling you, long term, they'll be really thankful. And it starts with us. So it starts here in Pendergast. And so we really want to make sure that people know about that incredible programming.
Thank you, Dr. Cruz. And I also want to give a shout out to our governing board, because they just won first place award with a national award, the Magna Award, from the National School Boards Association for the ASU Prep Digital Program. They were featured in a national magazine. They've been featured in media all over. So we're very, very proud of our school board for giving the support to move forward, and of course, to the students for all they're doing to further their education. So as we're winding down our program, what we'd love to do is know who our partners are. So if you would just take a minute and put in the chat who you are and where you're from, so we can thank you for being here. And also to let you know that this is our last community lunch and learn for the year, but we're going to be inviting you, as Dr. Cruz said, on June 24th. And on June 24th, we're going to be having that presentation about our ESSER funds. So you'll get to see what we're using those funds for. Deanna, thank you for being here from the Glendale Chamber of Commerce, one of our amazing partners. Who else is in the room? Okay, Tracy, Executive Director of School Connect. Tracy, thank you so much for being here. Tracy's done so much for our district also in terms of providing computers and support. Love Our Schools Day. They're a fabulous partner. Who else is with us today? Christy from GPCON. Oh my gosh, we love our GPCON partners. You guys are amazing. You do so much for us. We absolutely love you. Christy, thank you so much for taking the time to be here with us today. All right, who else is in the room? I know I saw Herman Orcutt is here from Orcutt Winslow. They're amazing partners with us. Herman also serves on our foundation. We're so very grateful to him. Who else can we do a shout out about as we're winding down? All right, nobody's coming forward, but I know a lot of our school staff is here. Thank you to our business partners for all their support. If you would like to partner with us, oh, Sunland, okay, thank you so much, Lisa. I was waiting for you to come forward. We love having you here. Thank you, you've done so much for us. The wonderful thing about partnering with Pendergast District is you know whatever you contribute goes right to our students and to our staff. And there's such gratitude. Everyone has worked so incredibly hard this year, and to know that you support them is so, so important. So anytime you want to partner with Pendergast, Pendergast wants to partner with you. We make it mutually beneficial, so it's something that's great for your business. Thank you so much. And also, something that's good for you and something that's good for our students. So we are so grateful for you. Any final parting words? Thank you so much for being here with us today, for learning with us. I know you're all going to go out and learn another language because you're taking that away with you. You see the quality of instruction that we have. You see how accountable we are for the funds for our community. We're really excited to see our next steps and what will happen with our bond and also with our academies and all the people that are here, all of our staff members who are really making this happen. We believe in you. Take care. We hope you have a great summer. We'll be sending out information to you. Take a second and fill out that survey. And take good care.